y'all don't mind, let's go back to a time we really used to have church. We used to have a good time, praising the Lord, in spirit and in truth.
I love them old church.
That old brother, pick up that old hymn book and
singing.
You knew exactly what he was gonna say. Sisters got happy.
I love them old church.
Folks start patting their feet, clapping their hands, and all of a sudden, he break off in a song, something like this.
This morning, we're going to have our lesson from the book of Romans chapter 7, one of the most complicated texts in the Bible, but I'm going to simplify it by just dealing with a part of it. I'm not going to get into the theological argument whether or not this is a sin nature text or whether or not this is his battle with the law itself or the old law, but I want to just deal with what he is speaking about and his struggle with sin, his struggle with what he identifies as sin. I don't know Paul's business, what sin he may be speaking of, or Islam. All I do know that he's in a struggle. And so for a subject matter, I want to take this morning and use the struggle is real. Look at your neighbor and say, the struggle.
The struggle.
The struggle.
The struggle.
The struggle.
The struggle.
Is real.
Is real.
Amen. Amen. If you don't believe it, just keep living. You'll find that the struggle
is real.
The struggle is real.
Oh, yes.
Amen. Amen. Listen to the difficulty it is to even read the text. As I just look at some of the text and look at the struggle that Paul is in as he writes in the book of Romans chapter 7, if you're marking in your Bible, hope that you are, beginning in our opening verse, around verse number 16. If then I do that which I would not, now that's just hard to say, if then I do that which I would not, or I allow not, for what I would, that I do not.
Mm-hmm.
But what I hate, that I do.
Man.
For what I hate, I do. And the things that I know to do right, I don't do.
Right.
How many of you can relate to knowing what is right, mm-hmm. but not able to figure out how to do
Hallelujah.
What's right all the time?
Amen.
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 I believe that good people struggle with life sometimes.
Oh, yes.
I believe that there are days like Paul that we leave out our house with every intention on doing what's right.
Amen.
Yes, sir.
I believe that not many people get up in the morning saying, I'm going to go live wickedly.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to go do something dastardly.
Yes.
But I believe many of us get up every morning wanting to do what's right.
Yes, that's right.
Paul says how to perform it, I don't know. Here's the complexity, because I'm man, I'm flesh.
Uh-huh.
And I'm spirit. Sometimes the things that I know to do what's right, I don't do.
All right.
And the wrong that I know I ought not to do.
Yes.
Yes.
I find myself doing stuff,
man,
that I should not do.
Oh, yes.
And don't look at me like that, because you do too.
Amen. Yes.
Amen. You do some stuff too.
Man.
Amen.
Amen.
You get up sometime and you know that when folk cut you off when you drive, you ought to just say, praise the Lord. But when they cut in front of you and they catch you on the wrong day,
amen,
you say some stuff in the car that don't nobody know but you and Jesus. And now you know that's not right. Amen.
Amen.
And you know it's not right because you look around to see if somebody watching, which finger
yes,
you put
sir.
Up when they went by. Amen.
Yes, sir.
Uh-huh. And so we can relate to Paul, and the struggle is real. And it seems like every time I have my mind made up to do what God would have me to do, that the devil intensifies his usury of my spirit.
Man. Come on now.
Just as soon as you say, I'm not going to do this or that anymore, it seems like this or that becomes the primary focus in your life. Y'all ought to say amen.
Amen. Amen. Come on now.
And then you look up one day, you did good for 2 days, but then you look up and then 10, 15 days later, you're back in the same old stuff that you were in before.
Amen.
Right. And here's my friend, because wherever good is, evil.
Yes.
It's always around.
Man.
And the problem is that only God understands us like he understands us.
Hallelujah.
God knows that when I make a mistake, that I'm in a process that he allows. Y'all ought to say amen.
Amen.
I'm glad that God is not like some of us.
Oh, yeah.
Because when I mess up, you don't worry about the process.
Oh, no.
You started to start the mess. Am I right about it?
Oh,
I'm glad that God knows that sometime when I say stuff I ought not say, that I'm in a process. And I know what I should have said, but I didn't say what I was supposed to say. But then God says, I have a law that wherever evil is, wherever good is, evil is always around.
Yeah, agree.
Come on.
Therefore,
now.
I cannot delight in even the good stuff that I do, because even the good stuff I do is clouded by my own personal issues, my own personal challenges.
Ooh,
that if I'm not careful, the good that I do becomes evil spoken of, because even in my good stuff, I'm just one step away from doing something I ought not to do.
Oh,
therefore, I don't get glory when I do good stuff, because I realize it's not me that do it, but it's the Lord that working in us.
Yes.
Oh, I wish I had somebody to have a prayer just for me. This is one of the most powerful scriptures that I've had a chance to study and to enjoy our reading and developing this lesson. In my personal struggle, I know that certain things are not good for me. But then the internal or the external law that suggests that my sin or my flesh craves and desires things that I ought not have.
Bring it on in now.
Has a mind of his own sometimes.
Yes, sir.
Yes.
There's some stuff that you crave that you know you shouldn't have.
Come on now.
That your flesh begins to take motion, as Paul says.
Uh-huh.
The sin begins to take motion.
Yes.
And you find yourself somewhere that you ought not be.
Woo!
Doing
yeah.
something that you should not be doing.
Uh-huh.
And throwing all the whole while, God is not happy with what I'm doing. Uh-huh. Oh, wretched man that I am.
Man.
Who shall deliver me from this body of sin? My friend, the struggle is real.
Yes,
if you think I'm lying, just try to walk out of here and not mess up for about 3 hours. Am I right about it? No sooner you get out the door, somebody look at you funny. The first thing you say is, Negro, who you looking at? Just left the church house. Already ready to get down and get with it. Am I right about it? Y'all about to tell the truth. Y'all know. The struggle is real. Get up in the morning and want to have a good day, and you look and they turn the cable off without notification.
Well.
No, you got to have your TV. And then you look at your bank account and found out you don't have enough money to get the cable on right now. Now you got to talk to yourself and go to talk to the people you live with that you haven't talked to because you've been watching cable.
Well,
and you find out when you talk to them, you don't even know these people. That you live, the struggle is real. Am I right about it? Then you start talking to them. I don't even like talking to you. Am I right about it? Get to your job and some brown nosing. Oh, Stephen, acting person in the job, brown nosing, tap dancing, snitching on you because you were 2 minutes late. Am I right about it? Not all the people are right up, they're going to write you up. Am I right about it? You don't say as well with my soul. Am I right? But the struggle is real.
Right.
You close the door and start talking about that. Man, am I right about it?
Man.
Oh, low life heifer wrote me up.
Woo!
Am I right about it? I hope you get fired sometime. I know how to forgive him, but I don't want to forgive. Y'all not say amen.
Amen.
I know how to let it go, but I don't want to let it go. I'm in my flesh. I want a fist fight. Y'all not say amen.
Amen.
The struggle is real.
Amen.
Yes, sir.
You're driving around minding your own business. And just as sure as I'm standing here,
uh-huh.
you're struggling on these three things all of your life. And you might as well decide that you're going to take God's way, because the struggle will not let up. It will not stop. It will intensify until
Man.
You understand that what you're going through is a real war, a real battle against good and evil.
Yes.
For we wrestle not against flesh and blood,
Say
but against principalities. They are real.
That's
against
real.
Powers is real.
Uh-huh.
Against spiritual witness is real in high places. And they're not playing. The struggle is real.
Bring it down.
Three things that you struggle against. Number one, the worst struggle you can have is your struggle with yourself.
All right.
Until you realize and stop blaming your mom and your daddy for who you are, you're going to be in a serious struggle.
Right.
Until you stop blaming the preacher in the church for your stuff, you're going to be in a whole lot of trouble.
Come on now.
Your struggle, your worst struggle you ever have is the struggle with yourself.
Right.
Can't nobody lie to you like you can lie to you.
Right.
Can't nobody make stuff up like you can make stuff up. Can't nobody get down there. Am I right about it? No man knows the spirit save the spirit of the man. Am I right about it?
Yeah.
And you know doing. You know that when you say you do, and inside you know you really don't.
Right.
You know the lies and the secrets that you keep.
Yeah.
You know you can look at folk and hate them and talk about Jesus in the same time. You know that you can steal and you can get down with the best of. You know you better than anybody else knows you. And the struggle is dealing with you.
Yes.
Don't worry about anybody else, but your first struggle is deal with yourself.
Amen.
This is what the same author says in 1 Corinthians chapter 15 and verse number 31. He says, I protest by your rejoicing of Christ that is in me. And then he says something remarkable. He says, I die daily. Every morning that you get up, you're in a struggle to not kill somebody else.
Woo!
You're in a struggle to kill yourself.
Oh,
man. But here's the problem. Your flesh don't want to die.
Right.
The good that I would do, can't do. I know I need to tell the truth on myself.
Yeah.
But how to tell the truth on myself, I can't figure out how to do that. How to stop lying about who I am, I don't even want to address. Paul says, I die daily. Every day you get up, you got to get up and say, I didn't even pray this morning. I just got up sinning. Beyonce put it this way. She said, I woke up. Like this, am I right about it?
Yeah.
I woke up looking like this. In my natural state, I exemplified the beauty of a coronation view that folk have. Sometimes we wake up in a sinful state of mind and we won't be honest with ourselves and stop and say, Lord, help me.
Yeah.
Amen.
Oh, I wish I had five people full of Holy Ghost right now. My heart is struggling not against somebody else, not against the devil. My heart is struggling is me and my internal mind, the intensity that I have to do. And the Bible says in 1 Corinthians chapter 9, verse number 27, he said, I have to bring my body under control. I have to bring those cravings under control. I have to bring that energy under control. I have to bring what Satan's doing through my flesh under control. He didn't say I got to go get Jesus to do it. He said, I have to be honest with myself. I have to deal with those cravings. I have to deal with those desires. I have to be honest and say, I got to resist the devil. He'll flee from me. But the problem is, I don't want to let him go.
Amen.
Long time ago, for some of you older folk, and not as young as I am, there was a song that said, loving you is wrong. I don't want to do right. Am I right about it? Being without you. I just rather spend the rest of my life with you. Y'all know that song. Friends say it's a shame to be in love with the married man.
Y'all
won't tell the
truth. I don't think we understand.
They don't understand what it's
saying. Come on.
You are married to Christ, but you date the devil. And every now and again, you get up in the morning, and the devil have your breakfast in bed. And you start smiling and start saying, baby, if loving you is wrong, I don't want to do right. And God is sitting back looking, saying, the first thing you got to do is decide within yourself if you want me or if you want him.
Amen.
And then you can't be honest and say, you know what? There are times I love evil, I love the devil, and I want to do what I want to do.
Amen.
This is what's remarkable about the text. Paul admits that. Paul says, the thing that I hate, I do. But underlining all of our stuff, our mess, there is always a part of us, because we are a dichotomy in nature, that know that what we're doing is wrong, but still love God with every piece of us that's in us, but don't have the power, don't have the strength to snatch away from the devil.
Uh-huh.
And the only way you're going to do it, you got to bring yourself under control. You got to die daily. You got to put yourself in a position to refrain from the stuff that help you sin. You have to make sure sometimes you got to sit around some real Christian folk so you can learn how to act like a Christian.
Yeah.
Because your nature by nature like to thug it out.
Amen.
But when you get around some folk that don't act like you and don't sound like you, you tend to strike. Y'all know I'm right. How many times had a preacher walked up and you know what kind of stuff you do, and the first thing you do, if you do it one day or another, what you do with the stuff you do with it?
Put it away.
You put it up? Yeah. Why you put it up? Why you put it up? You know it's wrong. You know it's wrong. Why you put it up? What you hiding for? What you hiding for? You know it's wrong. But now you're in a position in which what you're doing is not only embarrassing, but it also exposes the real
you.
And so what you do, instead of dealing with you and saying, Pastor, here's my stuff. guys. I'm trying to help each other. Y'all all right?
All right.
Amen. And isn't this a wonderful text?
Amen.
He admits his vulnerability. He admits his shortfalls. The solution to struggle with self is number one, you got a plan to get up and die daily. You got to pick some of that stuff and say, you know, today I'm not going down to where I used to go. If I could just make it today, I'm not going down here today. You know what? Today I'm not talking to her or him, because every time I talk to him, he got a bung. He wants me to take the bung and he wants to get high and lifted it. And I know if I go over there, I'm going to get high and lifted it. Today I'm not going over there because she wants me to do something that I'm not legally able to do. And she wants to do something strange for some change. And I can't do that. And so I can't go over there. Y'all not listening to me right now. That's some stuff you have to get up and plan not to go some places and see some places and do some stuff that you always do, because your nature is to sin and enjoy the sin that you into.
Amen.
I die daily.
Uh-huh.
And not only am I dying daily, but I have to take me, if y'all tell the truth, have to take me, have to put me I have to put me under guard. Sometimes you have to take you, and if you got a problem doing what's right with money, you might need to give your money to your honey. You might have to give your money to somebody else. But if you're going to take that money and buy some blow, you're going to take that money and buy her, you're going to take that money, do something ungodly, you may have to walk around with no money in your pocket to bring you under control. But when you get some money, you get crazy, you get out of your mind, you start thinking you balling, you start walking around thinking you tough, and before you know it, you done messed up your...
Amen.
So I have to bring myself under control.
Amen.
I have to bring myself, but you got to want to bring yourself under control. Lastly, when we look at this great passage of scripture, we find that Paul says that in order to deal with my bondage problem, in order to bring myself under control, in order to deal with myself, I don't have to die daily, I don't have to bring myself under control, but I need to pray to God. And I need to tell God the truth. Am I right about it? So I need to tell God that I'm doing what I'm doing because I like what I'm doing. And if you don't save me, I'm going to lose my soul. You need to stop blaming your good wife about the bad stuff you're doing. You got to stop blaming your good husband on the bad stuff you're doing. Stop blaming your children on what you're doing. Stop blaming bills on what you're doing. You ought to tell God the truth. You ought to say, God, I'm doing thus and thus. And Lord, if you don't reach down and save me, you're going to lose your child. I need you. Oh, I need you. It's not that I might do it. I'm going to do it. Let me tell you something. You keep on playing around with that man. men like you're playing with. Keep on playing around, talking noise. Talking about, that's why you can't leave, go to Bible, you can leave. Man, somebody take your husband. Mm-hmm. That's why I tell somebody looking right now. Mm. They said, now I know he know to do good. Yeah. But the good that he would, he does not. And that he want to do, he can't do.
All free.
All right.
Uh-huh. Oh, he don't know how to perform it. Now, you just keep on. Just keep on acting crazy. Susie will have your men. God, keep on that treating that woman. Keep on. Don't you know there's some men that look that sit at your wife's job just waiting for her to come in looking sad? Mm-hmm. She come with her head down. You think you bad. And she looking like she done been up all night crying. Mm-hmm. You sit up there looking at her. You thinking to yourself, you don't think the struggle real. Mm-hmm. He don't think fat meat greasy. Oh, you walk over to her. Hey, Michelle, how you doing? You know, I just noticed that, you seem so majestic, the way you walked in here. I know you're married, but I just seem so angelic. And if I had somebody like you, I'd pay all your rent. I wouldn't let you go to work. You have no right to work. Why is Anthony having you working? And this is named Anthony, isn't it? Does he know you working? Maybe I was just looking at my 900 credit score. And I was just thinking to myself, I need to let somebody have an American Express black card. And I was just wondering, could you use something today? Girl, you're so fine, I thought about you in all kind of ways. Don't mean to be disrespectful, but baby, I just want you to know I'm for real. Because the struggle is real. And if she come home and Anthony keep on telling you ugly, you ain't this, you ain't that, I don't want you, eventually somebody will have Michelle somewhere smiling. She'll sign divorce papers. She'll yell at the priest, don't call me then. You didn't call me before. That's another thing. Y'all stop calling me when all hell break out. You call me before the hell break out.
That's right.
I'm all this time, he didn't call. Right. He just another man. And then she got all her clothes packed, going to Johnny got your girl and go. And here come the phone, and brother, she might be leaving. Come on, I told her, don't go. Don't leave me. I'll be over there. As soon as I walk in there, the bad she done talked about me, she picking up skillets. She said, I whoop both of y'all. I whoop both of y'all. You get out of here, you take that line preacher with you. And I got something. Now, what I do? What can I do? We ought to work together when? Now! You ought to make sure that she feel I'm the best there. So when hell day come and you need somebody to say a word for you, I can come in there and say, Michelle, put your bags down. Right. The struggle is real. It's hard being married. It's hard being single. It's hard living. It's rough trying to make it through this world. Stuff is real in this world. And until you understand it's real, you will not get real with your problems.
Amen.
Final consequence the enemy has for us is that he wants your soul.
Oh, yeah.
He wants you dead. He wants you in hell right where he is. Mm-hmm. Oh, we can thank God this morning. Am I right about it?
Amen.
We can thank God because God knew that the struggle was what?
Real.
That the struggle was real. We can thank God this morning because we know that God knew that we were in a real battle with a real enemy.
Yeah.
And so he gave a real solution. Am I right about it?
Yeah.
See, some of us, we don't understand that when he sent his only begotten son, he sent his only begotten son because the struggle was real. Am I right about it? He knew that man couldn't take on an adversary like that. He knew before you got in your addiction that you would be addicted, that you need a savior to save you from addiction.
Amen.
He knew that when you went through economic racism, that economical racism would produce a recidivism in the prison system. And he already knew that the struggle was real, so he sent his word down in the cells. Am I right about it? He knew that the struggle was real, that suicide and homicide would become a part of the Christian vernacular, but it knew that salvation would bring life out of death. Am I right about it? Why did he do it? Because he knew that the struggle was real. Am I right about it? He knew that sometime you'll fall and won't want to get back up. But David said in the Psalm chapter 40, he said, I waited patiently on the Lord. He heard my cry. He lifted me up out of a horrible pit. So that's the part we missed. Sometimes God have to lift you up because you won't stand up. Sometimes you feel so low, you just lay there waiting to die. But God will reach down into those pits that you fall in. He'll lift you up because he knows that the struggle is real. He'll pick up. Y'all gotta say amen. Y'all gotta say amen. He knows that the struggle is real. He knows that there are nights like Jacob and
and verse number 26, where the angel is wrestling with Jacob, whether it's mythology or whether it's a dream or not, does not matter. But the fact of the matter is that Jacob is depicted being up all night. Am I right about it? The fact of the matter is sometimes in our life, we can't sleep at night because we're going through what we're going through. Don't tell me to have faith when I got to move out in the morning on the streets. Don't tell me to just hold on when everything around me is falling down. Don't tell me to sing a song when I'm crying and brokenhearted and don't feel like singing. Sometime you got to sit back and understand that the struggle is real. And when you can't sleep at night and when you're going through stuff, you need this presence of the Holy Spirit to deliver you from your sleepless nights. Not only are the nights that you can't sleep, there are times when we can't believe. Am I right about it? When you're sitting down in the hospital room and they said, look like all you do for your loved one is get them comfortable for tomorrow they'll surely die. You remember when the man walked up to Jesus and Jesus was there and he said, do thou believe? You remember he said in Mark 9, thank you, sir, in Mark 9 and verse 25, he said, Lord, I believe, but help me in my unbelief. Amen. What you mean? Yes. It's not that I don't believe in God, but I just believe that I'm so messed up that I can't be helped. Am I right about it? I believe that you are the Son of God, but I believe my stuff is so bad that you can't help me. And I'm just waiting, Lord, I believe, but help me in my unbelief. Right. I mean, how many needs help in your unbelief this morning?
Amen.
I mean,
Amen.
Don't we serve a God that'll help you in your unbelief?
Yes.
Stuff so bad that you can't, just not you don't believe in God, you just don't believe nobody can fix this problem. But the only person that can fix your problem is the Lord. Am I right?
Amen. Amen.
Not only this, we find ourselves, like Paul says, in 2 Corinthians chapter 4, verse number 8, he said, we're troubled on every side. We're troubled financially. We're troubled in the church. We're troubled in the school. We're troubled in this political season. Mm-hmm. We're troubled in our mind. We're troubled in our health and strength. There's trouble on every side. Yet we're not in despair. We're perplexed. Yet we're not depressed. What do you mean we're troubled on every side? Well, Paul put it this way in the text. He said that wherever good is, evil is always present. Am I right about it? What do I do when I'm in a bad situation? What do I do when I'm dealing with my stuff and I'm trying to deal with my struggle? My first struggle is myself. My second struggle is my spirituality. Well, my faith and my belief has been shaken to the core. My third struggle has been taken care of for me. That's what the text says. The text says in the last two verses that your struggle